Greetings, Guardians. My name is Byfe here. So, with a rather small reveal coming out of IGN in terms of actual new stuff aside from the survival game mode, I thought that now was the right time to talk about what I found on the farm, which was, relatively speaking, unique, and was most definitely a discovery made with the help of the people at Get Wrecked at the time being. In particular, I want to give a shout out to Receptor17, who was our Morse code translator for this one. Yes, you heard me correctly, Morse code. Now, why is Morse code in Destiny in the first place? Am I going completely down the rabbit hole? Let's go ahead and find out. So of course, the farm was only released for a short span of time, and the new social space was beautiful, of course. And there's much fun to be had in there, and there's even a few secret rooms. Of course, the one behind the Crypt Arc station is the one that had everyone's attention. But just as my first hour of the 2 hours I experienced within the farm went on, I ended up playing football with my mods, and someone in Get Wrecked, at the time being, actually walked into the room I was playing in and told me that they had discovered some signals in Morse code that were beeping in one of the rooms. It was at this point that my interest was piqued. Ever since Bungie's rather infamous Outbreak Prime exotic quest, featuring an ARG, the use of binary, and a secret raid puzzle that took the community a solid month to uncover, let alone the hours that many people spent solving it, I've been expecting Bungie to follow suit. So naturally, at the mention of Morse code, I was ready to jump down on this one and see what we could uncover from the hole that was being dug. Let's just go over what was discovered, and then we'll try to make some sense of it, although be warned, it's gonna get a little bit crazy. I mean, really, it looks like I have a bunch of dots on a page and I'm just gonna be drawing connections, and I wanna say this right now, I don't have any confirmation that this is verifiable, because this is crazy Destiny levels of spin foil right here. This is what happens when you really do take a look at everything in Destiny, and either it's the coolest little secret that Bungie left in, or alternatively, it's overanalyzing an environment. And I don't know which one, because Outbreak Prime was a thing. So, yeah, without much further ado, let's just go ahead and jump in. First of all, the room in which the signal was being found appears to be a massive communications hub, which was filled with computers and odd bits of comm technology, from old radios to the advanced tracking displays that we find in the Vanguard halls back in the tower, some of which do exist, and some of which show similar code to what's being shown on them now. But underneath all of that, there were a few distinctive sounds that could be heard if you had a really keen ear, and we actually turned our volume all the way up so we could hear this. One of them was a ticker tape-like sound, something similar to an old typewriter. The alternative was some kind of massive printer for this one, but there was nothing in the room, there were no printouts, etc., so we didn't pay this one much attention. There is, however, another older form of communication underneath. A series of beeps that could be heard, some long and some short. This, of course, was Morse code. For those wondering, the signal we heard in Morse code is being displayed on screen right now. Our problem was that the sound wasn't defined enough for us to interpret where each break in the signal was, so it was very hard to tell whether this was 4 letters, 2 letters, 3 letters, or maybe even just one word, although I don't believe that this would have had enough characters to make a single word that makes any sense. The group of people around me, of course, did include Receptor17, who was the active member of my Discord and the one who started the effort to translate the Morse code, and he came up with a few possible solutions for the codes, and I'm going to go ahead and show those in just a second. But before I say anything else, any Morse code experts out there, please do let me know what your interpretation of that code is. I'm going to go ahead and play the sound further down in the video as well so that you can listen for yourself. I'll turn the volume on that clip up as well so that it's not obnoxiously quiet. So, first of all, we have the following grouping of that Morse code. And to break this down for you, if you take this and translate it back into English, the first possible iteration of this stands for 26T. Doesn't really seem like it tells us much, but there is a second potential sequence, which feels like it's less likely because you can't necessarily hear the breaks, but if it does translate to this, there's some things we could potentially pull from this. Once again, Receptor and I are novices at Morse code, and whilst Teemo certainly was better than I was, I'm not going to go ahead and say that this is a thing until we've got double confirmation, so this still stands as theory. But the second potential code stands for IOM4. That is four characters, IOM4. Now the first signal, of course, is more frustrating to work with. You have a lot less relevance that can be pulled from it. The numbers 2 and 6 have no inherent meaning in relation to anything of late, and the letter T is pretty limited in terms of what it could stand for. Maybe the letter 6 is referencing the number of players in a fire team, and perhaps T refers to the traveler, but that is a hell of a stretch. Needless to say, neither of these solutions are long enough to be coordinates given that one is only three characters and the other's only four, but the second solution has a little bit more to it in terms of the possibilities of what it could mean. IOM4 could actually stand for a few things, but immediately what jumped out to me were the first two letters, IO, which is actually the name of a destination in Destiny 2. Io is one of the four Galilean moons of Jupiter, the last world terraformed by the Traveler before the collapse, and a place that was particularly sacred to warlocks. So perhaps there's something with an Io, but what about the M4? Could M4 simply stand for Mission 4? Could it be some kind of designation to its status within the moons of Jupiter, given that it is one of the first four moons discovered around the planet, hence the M standing for moon, and the 4 could hint to its status as one of those four Galilean moons? If you're a Morse code savant, again, give us our interpretation and give us yours, and tell us whether we've mucked this up or tell us whether you've found something on your own. I'd be really interested to hear this. If you want to hear it, I'm going to go ahead and play that Morse code for you again just now, so I will be silent for about 20 seconds, the background audio of the farm will be much louder, so I hope you guys can interpret something from this. Now, there were actually some follow-up pieces of information which seem very disparate, but I thought were worth still discussing. It would appear that every screen within the farm has the same form of information, which appears to be a Linux command screen running a variety of programs. I apologize, I could not find the person who originally recommended this, but regardless, a member of my community did this, so once again, you guys are pulling through the comments section, the tweets, every single one of them is something that leads us further to the truth, so thank you very much. From these screens, however, there were a few interesting pieces of information as the letters on the screen ran by. Most of these were broken up into abbreviated phrases, but the one that really caught my eye, and those of everybody around me at the time, was a simple string of characters here. 0.0, 1.4, 0.08, 0.17, exclamation point tool, exclamation point, find RASP logs. 15320 default. So yeah, the interesting part of that is needless to say the part where it seems to say RASP logs, RASP potentially standing for Rasputin. However, I want to leave you with a little look at one of these screens in slow motion whilst I keep talking about this, because there's still a ton of codes running by, and I don't know if any of these have meaning. If they do have some kind of meaning, I would much prefer that you guys take a look at them and maybe discover them for yourselves. Hopefully this will be a helpful archive for those of you who are within the secret cracking community within Destiny's raids, and if you really want to go ahead and lend your hand to this and maybe see if there is something behind it, we shall see. Regardless, let's start talking about the potential theory that we could bring to this to make some of the information we have here make some sense. And keep in mind, this is bold and unverified, so yeah, take everything with a grain of salt. I don't know what's right and what isn't. So starting off, let's talk about the Morse code. It's pretty clear that that is a signal that's being received and not sent. Whilst the monitor on the computer is not sending things, it appears to be accessing or attempting to access something. The term tool find RASP logs indicates a function, an action that is being taken. So let's make the really bold jump and state that the computer screen is trying to contact Rasputin, the AI warmind, and let's make a further giant leap and state that the Morse code forming IOM4 is actually a form of response from Rasputin. I know, crazy, but just follow me for a second here. This could potentially lead to something. The first thing we should do is see what the link between Io and Rasputin is, if any. Well, Rasputin was an AI warmind built during the Golden Age. The warmines as a whole were constructed to guard specifically over territories within our solar system. For example, Rasputin was, as far as we can tell, the first and most powerful, if the hints in the grimoire are to be believed, and as a result, he was the war mind responsible for the guardianship of Earth. Meanwhile, the territory of Mars was left under the watchful eye of Charlemagne, and so on and so forth. Now, in Mission 5, when we activated the communications array, we allowed Rasputin to take over the systems of every dormant warmind in our solar system as far as we've met thus far, meaning that Rasputin is capable of utilizing all their weapons, platforms, and warsats. So our next question has to be as follows. Was there a warmind of Io? And if so, did Rasputin take control of it? Now, the likely answer to our first question is no. Io was quite specifically the last place the Traveler touched before the darkness arrived. Prior to this, it would have been nearly impossible to get a warmind built there because the planet's surface was being torn apart by hostile gravitational forces from Jupiter and Ganymede. In layman's terms, basically that means that Io was constantly being ripped apart by earthquakes, volcanoes, and toxic gases galore. So yeah, no safe way to build a warmind. However, what if the warmind was in space? You see, there's actually a few references to warminds that appear alongside references to Io, in particular with the ghost fragment Legends 2, which mentions our elusive benefactors known only as the Nine. The passage in particular of relevance is as follows. The Nine are survivors of the Cisjovian colonies that made a compact with an alien force to ensure their own survival. The Nine are deep orbit warminds who weathered the collapse in hardened stealth platforms. The Nine are the firstborn awoken, and their minds now race down the field lines of the Jupiter Io flux tube. Those are all the ones that are relevant at this exact moment in time to the territory of the Jovians and to warminds. I do not believe that all of those are relevant to this particular discovery, if it is one. In particular, I don't believe that the awoken one is relevant just because of the nature of that discovery. So yeah, let's break some of this down first. Let's start with the whole deep orbit warmind part. If this signal is telling us to go to Io and it just so happens to be a communication from Rasputin, it could well be sending us to a station that isn't actually a warmind, but instead is another link by which Rasputin can control further warminds, including those deep orbit warminds and their harder to locate stealth platforms. Secondly, we could have to consider the idea that Rasputin is telling us something more. The other two passages concerning the survivors of the Cisjovian colonies and the minds of the Firstborn Awoken could also potentially link into this, but that's purely due to the location that's being pointed out of Io and the Jovian moons, aka Jupiter's moons generally. This of course goes without mentioning the absolutely stunning amount of jargon that goes into this, and this is why I don't want to go ahead and just go any deeper. Because, frankly, I don't even want to start explaining what the Jupiter Io flux tube is. If that is the case and I would have to explain that, I'd probably drive half of you insane or asleep, possibly a combination of the two. So, to summarize, from what I can tell, if we're really going to take the most cursory, crazy theory that we've potentially got, look out for something when you have your fourth mission on Io. Who knows, this could be part of a bigger ARG. Also, it could not be. It could just simply be Morse code in the background of the farm, and if that is the case, then I'm incredibly disappointed in Bungie. I am not someone who was educated in cracking codes, but regardless, I'm sure someone else out there is. And if you are, you have the signal in this video. I'm going to go ahead and timestamp those points at which I show off the Morse code sequence as we heard it, and also the small audio clip of Morse code. Keep in mind that this did repeat over and over and over again, but realistically, I don't believe that there's any variation between it, and the only thing that I'm skeptical of is whether we got the breaks between the Morse code letters wrong. So yeah, that's what I'm really questioning here. I'll also of course leave the zoomed in footage of the monitors, and anybody who wants to go ahead and check out those can do so. But if you have any indication of what this may be, go ahead and leave it in the comments section down below, or maybe chase this up on Reddit, find out for yourselves, guys. This is something that I want to put out there as a resource for you guys, because it's pretty clear that this is down to a greater mind than mine alone to solve. I am not a codebreaker. I did not get anywhere close to even understanding the Outbreak Prime ARG, let alone contributing to it. So for anybody who is in that codebreaking community, here you go. This is for you. This is like our little resource packet. Go ahead, do the problems if there are any. Tell me whether I'm just, you know, breathing hot dust here or whether there's something behind this, and if there is, full credit to you. Once again, big shout out to Receptor for being the Morse code translator on this, and I hope that you enjoyed this video or found it interesting. If you did, please go ahead and leave a like on the video. And if there's anything further that you want in terms of Destiny content, do remember that you can subscribe. And if you do that, then you can also hit the bell next to subscribe to turn on email notifications so that you never miss a video. But of course, your viewership is quite enough for me. And in the meantime, my name has been, my name is Bife. Perodacia Arastra. I'll see you, Starside.